Hello everyone. We'll be starting from the Laplace transform as a series, and in every session you'll be getting the concepts clear for one single property. So you'll be getting that all properties, and you have to be tune in with all the sessions done in the previous. So it's every session is getting connected because I'll be using the previous property to solve the next. Previous property to the solve next. Okay, so I'll be introducing today's session as a Laplace transform and how to solve the questions based on the definition. By the end of the session, you'll be able to solve the examples using the definition of Laplace transform. Let me just make you introduce with the background and the importance of Laplace. So Pierre de Laplace in 1749 to 1827 used this concept much earlier in 1799 while developing the theory of probability, which is this originated from the operational methods applied by the English engineer Oliver Heaviside, who is from 1850 to 1925, to the problems in electrical engineering. Unfortunately, the Heaviside statement was unsystematic and lacked rigor, which was placed on sound mathematical footing by Brumwich and Carson during 1916 to 17. So Heaviside's operational calculus is best introduced by means of a particular type of definite integrals called Laplace transform. So it's a very powerful mathematical technique which is used to solve linear differential equations, systems of simultaneous differential equations, partial differential equations, and integral equations applicable to continuous function, piecewise continuous function, periodic function, step function, and impulse function, and important applications in mathematical physics, optics, electrical engineering, control engineering, signal processing, and many, many more. So I have listed here very few, and this credit goes for this particular information to the book of Professor B.S. Greyval. Okay, the definition, let f of t be the function of t defined by all t greater than or equals to 0, and then the Laplace transform of f of t is defined by L f of t or f bar of s, and is defined as Laplace transform of f of t is equals to f bar of s, which is also equals to integration from 0 to infinity e to the power minus st f of t dt, and which is provided the integral exists where s is a parameter, real or a complex. So s might be a real number or a complex number. Now, if we'll observe this definition, this is one of the notation we are getting introduced here, which is known as an operator. It's an operator. It's known as a Laplace as an operator. What do you mean by operator? Now, whenever we are solving the function, we are finding out the differentiation or the integration, the differentiation of sine of x, differentiation of sine of x with respect to x will give me the cos of x, right? So what is happening here? I'm getting the sine of x getting transformed to cos of x as another function. Similarly, integration is also getting transformed one function to the other function. So this is known as an operator. This is known as an operator. Similarly, we have L or a Laplace as an operator, which is getting transformed. So this f of t, this function is getting transformed to a function f bar of s, f bar of s, right? And therefore, this is known as an operator. So it's time to the frequency domain. Time domain to the frequency domain, it is getting transformed. Okay, few books are using this notations as f bar of s or capital F of s or phi of s as one of the notations. So let us go for a few examples. Find the Laplace transform of f of t, t when it is in the interval 0 is less than t is less than 1, and it is 0 when t is greater than equals greater than 1. So the definition follows Laplace of f of t is equals to 0 to infinity e to the power minus f of t dt. So it's 0 to 1 e to the power minus st into t. So if you'll observe this f of t, this role of f of t, we are dividing it. Why? Because this f of t has been given to us in two intervals. So first interval is in this t and second is in 0. But what is the limit for this t? The function f of t is t only in the interval 0 to 1. So this, if you'll observe, this integration is from 0 to 1 e to the power minus st dt. Okay, so just a minute, I'll just make me laser pointer so you will understand it. So it's integration from 0 to 1 e to the power minus st t dt, because the function, the value of the function here from 0 to 1 it's t, and from 1 to infinity it's been given to us as 1. Sorry, it's been given to us as 0. So it's 0, 1 to infinity becomes 0 here, the value of the function, which is equals to, so now if you observe here, this is e to the power minus st into t. So here u into v rule of the integration would come. So li a t e, according to li a t, my t is the first function, e to the power minus st as the second function. So first function as it is in the first case, second function, the integration of the second function minus the differentiation of the first function, that is first function is t over here, the differentiation of one, sorry, t is one. And again, I have to integrate this e to the power minus st upon minus s with respect to s again, because if you'll observe, with respect to t again, so it's e to the power minus st upon s square 0 to 1, because the limit is 0 to 1. And if you'll observe the second, this integral becomes 0 because of the value of the function becomes 0 here. So what is the next step? Next step is I'm putting the, it's minus of, so it becomes minus t e to the power minus st upon s, e to the power minus st upon s square integration from 0 to 1. And therefore, if I put the upper limit minus the lower limit, so upper limit becomes, so what are we supposed to replace as? Because we have done the integration with respect to t, so we are replacing every t by 1 in the first bracket here and every t by 0 in the second bracket. Because whenever we are substituting upper limit and the lower limit, it has to be upper limit full minus the lower limit full. So it will be, so e to the power, so if you observe, every t has been replaced as 1 over here. So it's minus e to the power minus s by s, minus e to the power minus s upon s square. So t has been replaced as 1. And here in the second, minus 0. So every t will be replacing as just 0. Because if t is 0 over here, so it becomes 0 minus 1 upon s square. Because e to the power minus 0, so it will be, it will give me e to the power 0, that is 1. So it's 1 upon 1 square, and therefore e to the minus, so e to the power minus s will come out of the bracket, so it's minus e to the power minus s, and the bracket will be remain as 1 by s plus 1 upon s square plus 1 upon s square. So because the next second bracket we don't have e to the power minus s as, so this is what is minus of e to the power minus s plus 1 upon s square plus 1 upon s square. And we'll just simplify, we'll take out 1 upon s square outside the bracket, we'll be having this as the answer. So it's just simple integration. So we have, whenever we are dealing with the Laplace transform or the Fourier series, we have to be very thorough with our integration. Actually, this Laplace transform is a generalized case of Fourier series. Okay, so next question is, find the Laplace transform of f of t sin t 0 to pi, and t is becomes, the function becomes 0 for d greater than pi. So Laplace, the definition, again, I'm just replacing my f of t with respect to 0 to pi and pi to infinity, because this function has been given to me into two separate intervals, 0 to pi and pi to infinity. 0 to pi, the function value becomes sine of t because it's been given to me, and the rest of the function becomes 0 here. And therefore, if you'll observe here, it's e to the power minus ax into sine of bx dx, this formula. So we have got it here, e to the power ax upon a square plus b square into a sine of b minus b into cos of b. So what you'll observe here, so if I will make it here, so what is my e to the power ax sine of bx? So if you'll observe my b, the value of b is 1 over here and a is s, right? It's minus s. So that is why it has come. So it's e to the power minus st upon s square, that is a square plus b square into a sine of bx. So a is minus of s. So if you'll observe here, this is my a over here. This is small a. Just bear with my this here, and this b is 1, right? So this b is 1 here, so it's minus of cos of t. And if I'll put the limit 0 to pi, again as previous what we have done. The limit for pi, every t is getting replaced as pi, minus every t is getting replaced as 0. So if we'll do that, it will give you this step. So every t is being replaced as pi over here, minus of every t is replaced by 0 over here. And therefore, this is e to the power minus pi s upon s square plus 1 plus 1 upon s square plus 1. Why? Because its sine of pi will go to 0 here, right? And cos of pi will give me minus of 1. And therefore, I will get my final answer as 1 plus e to the power minus pi s upon s square plus 1. So this is what is the Laplace transform of this function. So Laplace transform of function f sine of t in the interval 0 to pi. And f of t becomes 0 for t greater than pi. The value of this Laplace of this function is 1 plus e to the power minus pi s upon s square plus 1. Okay. From this series, I've decided to give my learners a very brainstorming session, a small session. Whatever the questions I have solved in the exam, in the series, I have been given you as this one inclusion, that is self-observation. So whatever the questions I have done, similar kind of question I'll be giving you for this particular slide. So just you follow the video, and at this end, at the end, you have to solve these questions. Then you will get thorough with this type of examples. So I'll be solving 2 to 3 questions, and similar questions would be given to us this slide, that is known as a self-observation. So this is a small inclusion from my side, so that you will get thorough knowledge of your. And along with that, I have given you the answers. Purposely, I'm not giving you the steps so that you can cross-check your answer using the slide. I hope you will understand and you will practice, take the advantage of this self-observation slide as well. Thank you. Happy learning.